This is part 2, episode 137. Little fly, you dare show such insolence. Crocel didn't stop at that. After the first strike came off smoothly, the long blade chopped at Houchin, drawing a pitch-black brilliance onto the sky, which aimed straight at Long Houchin like a bolt of thunder. Underscore his blade's edge seems to be using an ability similar to spiritual Highland underscore, Long Houchin determined instantly from the first blow. What he didn't know at all was that in the demon's ranks, every demon god, without his own clan, certainly had far a less influential strength, but the demon god emperor encouraged them, frequently giving them the priority for some powerful equipment. Therefore, individual demon gods had comparatively better practical fighting strength. And although the demon god of clear vision Crocel's strength was ranked rather low among the individual demon gods, he couldn't possibly have obtained the 49th seat without sufficient strength. He was a real powerhouse of the ninth step, and furthermore, had the clear vision technique at his disposal. If his cultivation reached the point of being able to unleash a domain, maybe he could rank among the top 36. In this probing, Long Houchin immediately suffered a loss. However, as a god's chosen one, he naturally couldn't let himself continuously suffer losses. Seeing the second attack of the enemy arrive, Long Houchin's figure strangely disappeared without warning nor trace. Underscore bang, dot underscore Crocel's attack landed directly on the Tower of Eternity, causing a series of buzzes. He couldn't help but blank out. Even with the clear vision technique, he actually couldn't tell out how Long Houchin had gone off. Long Houchin obviously couldn't possibly teleport himself back to Shingmo Dalu. A time of adjustment was required before teleporting back, and besides, he could absolutely not leave Crocel here by himself. Otherwise, if he explores and finds out about the deep secrets of the Tower of Eternity, and manages to obtain something, things could become a real pain. In a flash of light, Long Houchin reappeared in his previous location, and this time, the hill-sized five-headed Haoyue was alongside him. Outside from the teleportation to the Tower of Eternity, Long Houchin also had his blood contract packed with Haoyue. In the battle against Crocel inside the Tower of Eternity, Long Houchin's greatest reliance was the possibility to show his full abilities without any worries. Even if he didn't manage to kill Crocel, the latter still had no way to escape the Tower of Eternity. Grow Haoyue's five heads snarled together, and deep purple intent rushed forth from him, shrouding the opposite Crocel. Immediately, the previously proud-looking demon god of clear vision lost his head as if facing a monster, already full of shock. You're. Immediately, he became unable to finish his sentence. Long Houchin obviously understood that the opponent had recognized his identity. Recovering the divine snail shield, he pointed his right hand forward and immediately let golden light surge out from him. Yating charmingly appeared in front of him, and in her hands were held up two heavy swords. Master. Yating bowed slightly, holding the two heavy swords out before Long Houchin. Long Houchin took up the Aria of the Goddess of Light, and then blew rain hibiscus of light. Immediately, his manners made an earth-shattering change, with mighty sword intent bursting from him without reserve. His aura was far greater than before. You underscore that underscore human, underscore that underscore human. Crocel stabilized his posture after drawing 10 or so meters back. He tenaciously stared at Haoyue, bursting with great fury. Immediately, he became totally unable to maintain his precious calm. The demon gods succeeded each other through many generations, but not all memories were passed between them. The stronger the demon god, the more of the past memories he'd inherit. That's how the demon god emperor could immediately speak out Haoyue's other name, but this 49th ranked demon god of clear vision Crocel couldn't tell it outright. But his engraved instincts were still present. Although he couldn't say Haoyue's identity, he had a deep, threatened feeling that came out, alongside an extremely great fear. Last time, when Long Houchin vanquished the goblin demon god Seer, he immediately had Haoyue transform into armor and merge with his golden foundation armor, but he hadn't had time then to observe Haoyue's changes. He only had felt that Haoyue was a lot more powerful, but giving another look, Haoyue's stature had already surpassed 15 meters, and his aura became more substantial. Faintly, a unique imposing demeanor was coming out from him. Based on Long Houchin's senses, the current Haoyue hadn't yet broken through the ninth step, making him inferior to Houchin, roughly reaching the peak of the seventh step. But his aura at the peak of the seventh step could actually instill such a fear to a powerhouse of the ninth step, such as the demon god of clear vision Crocel. Why was that? Long Houchin tried to ask Haoyue many times about the issue in the past, but the latter avoided the subject every time, sometimes looking clearly at a loss, as if unable to recall it himself. Furthermore, at the time he had followed Long Haochen, he had only one head, and gained his second one with the help from Haochen's blood. How could such a small Haoyue know so many things already? In Long Haochen's guesses, the real threat to the demons was very probably Haoyue's ancestor. And the same goes for the ones from his own world. In other words, Haoyue's species was very strong, and he would definitely keep growing stronger in the future. That's Long Haochen's judgment, therefore making it natural that Haoyue wouldn't know about his own such circumstances. Haoyue now had five heads of different elements, being light, fire, wind, water, and poison. Of his five heads, Little Light was the central one, its neighboring ones being Little Flame and Little Wind, and the outer ones Little Blue and Little Purple. The five heads looked at Crocel with cold gazes, faintly leaking out an aura of hatred. Just like the demons seemed terrified when running into Haoyue, Haoyue showed an intense hate in front of the demon gods. Could they have an innate blood enmity? Long Haochen didn't understand this even one bit. After all, Haoyue wasn't a being from this dimension. So how could he show such hatred to the demon gods? It could be estimated to be a bad compatibility engraved in his genes. On his thick neck, Haoyue had another protruding area. This bulge was extremely large, and according to Long Haochen's knowledge, one reaching to this point could break at any time, followed by another evolution from him. Perhaps it would give birth to a sixth head. Haoyue let out another low roar, letting out a dense fighting intent. He was seeking to fight, and wanted to rush straight at Crocel. Of course, Long Haochen didn't let him do that. Haoyue was after all still only at the peak of the seventh step. If the enemy's attack inflicted heavy damage on him, Haochen would regret it greatly. After a short time of soul-bounded communication, Long Haochen soared high, leaving Haoyue's back. Yating still remained at the same area, and started to chant. Long Haochen didn't summon Star King here. The Tower of Eternity was filled with an intense aura of death, and he was unwilling to let it influence him. But was it really that Long Haochen didn't have other forces than Haoyue and Yating at his disposal? Of course not. Although unwilling to utilize this force, he came to have restraining fears after the previous display of strength Crocel showed. Therefore, he didn't dare show any reservations. Four rays of light lit successively on Long Haochen's chest and shot out. The blue and yellow rays landed on his back, while the red and green one covered his two sides. Imposing auras surged out from them. These were the four powerful holy guards, the 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th. Due to Long Haochen not proceeding to enter deeper in the Tower of Eternity, the four holy guards didn't undergo any evolution, and still retained a cultivation at the seventh step. But the assistance from the four powerhouses, especially with their personal expertise, gave Long Haochen a considerable help. Is that considered ganging up? Long Haochen suddenly had this queer thought. Haoyue, Yating, the four holy guards, and Long Haochen himself. That was the entirety of the forces at his disposal. In itself, these were already close to ordinary members composing a king-grade demon hunt squad, and a considerably strong one at that. Crocel gradually calmed down from his state of terror, finally feeling a threat to his life. Long Haochen wasn't frightening, the four holy guards weren't even given a look, but Haoyue's appearance made him lose his head. A thin golden fog rose in his surroundings, storing power. The orange glint of the golden foundation armor rose immediately, and in Long Haochen's hands, the aria of the Goddess of Light and Blue Rain, Hibiscus of Light projected their own brilliance as well. With the support from the golden foundation armor, Long Haochen had a strong backup of spiritual energy, and spent almost no effort to undo the seal on the aria of the Goddess of Light. At the same time, Blue Rain, Hibiscus of Light let out its greenish-blue brilliance as equipment of the epic tier. The orange and greenish-blue colors didn't harmonize perfectly, but carried an extremely dazzling look alongside the golden color released from Long Haochen's body. Haoyue's five large head's eyes were filled with thin fluctuations of purple intent, as those nine purple lines atop Haochen's head started to light up. Haoyue's right foreleg inclined to the right side, letting out a loud bang as it landed onto the ground. His whole body embedded itself here like a boulder, and on his five large heads, five different colored radiances kept rising. More terrible, they were not only focusing on the offense. From Little Light, Radiant World was directly used on Long Haochen. The other heads were visibly preparing for other magic, as those other four heads swayed lightly. Crocel, being the demon god of clear vision, even if he was even more afraid than that, he knew that he couldn't keep waiting. If the enemy was let to prepare his attacks, he would face an unavoidable death. Ads by Pub Future. Filled with great will to survive, Crocel yelled and rushed forward, just like a dark blue bolt of lightning. Flapping the six wings on his back, he went directly for Long Houchen. Crocel could of course tell out that Houchen was the core of these enemies. As long as he could be killed, the others would be no threat. The same even went for Hao Yue, as he could sense the existence of a contract between them. Two blade projections were launched, not at Long Houchen, but at the 12th and 10th Holy Guards. The demon god of clear vision's locking ability could hardly be avoided by these two. Crocel didn't even look them in the eye. An ice-cold dark blue radiance burst out from his eyes, directly launched toward Long Houchen's eyes. A mental attack. Being a demon god of the psychic type, mental magic was Crocel's field of expertise, and as his cultivation reached the ninth step, a mental shock launched by him could sometimes even burst the enemy's head. Long Houchen didn't attempt to dodge. Crocel's most fearful aspect was his ability to land all his attacks by relying on clear vision's godly pull, giving no chance of escape. Hao Yue's heads roared simultaneously, all eyes colored in intense purple intent. At the very moment, Hao Yue and Long Houchen seemed almost to be joined as one. As the purple light in Hao Yue's eyes flashed, Long Houchen's both eyes also turned purplish gold colored. The four holy guards immediately responded to Crocel's two blades. Being left without a way to perform dodging maneuvers, the four holy guards were greatly suppressed. But even so, they had their own means. Two icy blue radiances came out from the 11th staff, landing on the two black blade projections. The spiritual highland-like projections obviously were stopped by such a simple magic, but it slightly delayed their arrival. Right at that time, two thick earth walls appeared in front of the 12th and 10th. More formidably, its appearance was followed by a great change. In the blink of an eye, it changed from earth walls to earth spheres, at least three times thicker than the walls used to be. In the meantime, the 10th and 12th Holy Guards drew back very rapidly. The 10th Holy Guard had basically no worries at all. Speed was his greatest field of expertise, so although the enemy's attack was unavoidable, at least he could extend the time before the collision by increasing their distance. On the other side, the 12th Holy Guard struck his blade on the ground to propel himself backwards at great speed. Bang, bang. The two earth balls were destroyed at the same time, but this time, the great mastery of the 9th Holy Guard became fully visible. Turning into spheres one after another, they blocked the way of attacks of the demon god of clear vision Crocel. When that spiritual highlandized energy reached the two holy guards at last, it was finally stopped by two large and thick ice walls. Relying on their great magic control, the 9th and 11th guards did their utmost to help the other two stop this strike. But even so, when the 10th and 12th stopped the residual energy of the attacks, it still shook the whole Tower of Eternity unto the edges. From this could be seen how powerful the demon god of clear vision Crocel was. A powerhouse of the ninth step was truly a terrible thing for opponents of a lower level. However, Crocel actually suffered a loss. The mental shock attack he launched from his eye didn't have the slightest effect upon landing on Long Houchen's purplish golden eyes. It was as if a shield had been erected outside Long Houchen's eyes, forcibly stopping its way. In the meantime, the Aria of the Goddess of Light in his right hand slowly struck. This attack from Long Houchen was very slow. The accumulated sword intent, released at the blade's tip, vanished gradually, as an orange brilliance was taken in and sent out from the tip, faintly releasing multicolored golden light. Indeed, under the effects from Long Houchen's spiritual highland and his sword intent, the Aria of the Goddess of Light reached its state approaching the divine tool stage. This was obviously not only due to his increased cultivation, but more importantly thanks to the benefits brought by the fallen meteor nurturing the two heavy swords. Yating, having fused with the Saint Spiritual Stove, had the best nurturing force. She integrated the fallen meteor into the two swords through the Saint Spiritual Stove, increasing their quality all along, though that upgrade was still unfinished. As the heavy swords gained in quality, the fallen meteor was increasingly more used up, so the nurturing couldn't be kept up for much longer. However, this was something that Yating didn't yet have the time to inform Houchen about, but even so, these two swords easily reached the epic tier level, especially Blue Rain, Hibiscus of Light, which used to only reach its premises before that. As he used his two blades as support while rushing forward, letting out crisp and clear sounds, Crocel absolutely didn't dare receive this strike from Long Houchen with his body. Right at this time, the image of a six-winged angel appeared behind Long Houchen, closely adhering to his back. Immediately, it sharply increased the brilliance released by his two swords, while Long Haochen's mental force became unable to restrict the terrifying sword intent accumulated inside the swords. This was a light spell of the eighth step, serving as support coming from Yating, Blazing Angel's Kiss. This ability has considerable boosting effects, definitely ranked among the best light elemental spells of the eighth step. It enables Long Haochen's gathering speed of light essence to increase, while turning all his spiritual energy into spiritual highlandized state for a duration of 30 seconds. In other words, the ability Blazing Angel's Kiss directly turned Long Haochen into a powerhouse of the ninth step for 30 seconds. Its boost was comparable to Star King's Star Domain, with the only difference being that Star Domain could last for a long time. Bang! In a single sword versus dual swords, Long Haochen stumbled three steps back, and Demon God of Clear Vision's charging stance was stopped forcibly. Long Haochen's sword strike was terminated, but overwhelming sword intent kept gushing out from his body frantically, to the extent that Crocel was not even able to chain a next attack due to the trembling cold reaction of his whole body. Still, the blades in Crocel's hands had considerably terrible spiritual highlandized energy accumulated. Pushed back, Long Haochen was also unable to follow up. But no matter what one could say, he managed to stop Crocel's charge head-on. As the battle was just getting started right now, four of Hao Yue's heads spurted out four magic spells, attacking Crocel. Little Flame had sprayed a fire dragon, aimed straight at Crocel's body, and Little Green released wind blades forming a hurricane, enveloped around the fire to form a fusion of wind and fire. Little Blue and Little Purple also completed a pair of combinatorial spells. And Bluish Purple Spear elevated itself in midair without a sound. As Crocel's surroundings were covered by the wind and fire, this Bluish Purple ray shot, without a sound, aiming for the top of Crocel's head. Getting Hao Yue's back up, Long Haochen crossed his swords in front of him. His whole body's force was poured inside the heavy swords, as their spiritual energy reached the peak. Immediately, the heavy swords shook lightly, letting out more and more brilliant glows. Their rich and powerful radiance increased as the sword tip retracted gradually. Long Haochen was simply forcefully stifling the leaking sword intent from the boost of Blazing Angel's Kiss back inside the swords. The aria of the Goddess of Light looked like an orange gelatin dessert, brilliant and full of allure. And Blue Rain, Hibiscus of Light, was like a dark green jadeite, full of vitality and lustrous like a nascent bud. A dense golden fog kept rising anew, and intense golden flames instantly ascended onto the golden fog, as Long Haochen was exerting his whole strength. Due to facing Hao Yue's attack, Crocel's strength seemed as if suppressed. All his abilities lost about a fifth of their efficiency, and he looked extremely prudent. Pointing both his blades in opposite directions, one to the sky and the other one to the ground, dark blue radiance reappeared in his eyes, spreading out from within. Then he started spinning in the same place, turning into a black pillar of light colliding against those two spells. The gap of cultivation manifested without a doubt. The fire and wind whirlpool was first destroyed, as the extremely sharp fire dragon was totally unable to make its way inside the black pillar. Then the ice spear launched at him was dodged in a flash, leaving no trace at all. The black light vanished and Crocel staggered backwards. On his left shoulder had appeared a faint dark purple trace, and his left arm was slightly bent down. Hao Yue's attack unexpectedly dealt some damage to him. This felt really incredible, that at the peak of the seventh step, he could actually wound the demon god of clear vision of the ninth step. The other three spells were actually covers for Little Purple's attack. Little Blue wrapped ice around it, transforming it into water in a split second. Although merely a drop had made it past Crocel's defense, its terrifying paralyzing poison was enough to completely benumb the left arm of a powerhouse of the ninth step. Demon gods have very high resistance against poison, but Hao Yue's poison was visibly out of the ordinary. Due to the paralyzing poison, Crocel's arm would need some time to return to normal, in other words, to fully dispel the poison. But Long Haochen remained unmoving, still using storing power. The ones attacking next were the four holy guards. Crocel had a sudden heavy feeling, as a sparkling and translucent brilliance shone above his head in the shape of a diamond-like spear. In the meantime, an icy blue ring instantly enveloped his body, blowing up immediately. It produced an extreme chilliness, as a red and a green figure took advantage of that opportunity to rush to him suddenly, launching offenses almost frantically. But right because of the effect from Hao Yue's poison, Crocel managed to completely calm down. Hao Yue's attack certainly inflicted some damage to him, but also made him realize that the creature he feared to such extent was actually far from his own strength. And under these circumstances, he displayed fully his strength as the demon god of clear vision. In a disadvantaged situation, the calmed-down Crocel was unconditionally fearful. Stomping heavily onto the ground with his left feet, he released a black ray from inside his body, forcibly destroying the 11th ice ring and slowing down the diamond spear launched at him. Then the blade in his right hand struck with an efficiency reaching the maximum. A blade projection was launched, covering 270 degrees, aimed at Long Haochen, as its peak coincided to meet with the diamond spear. And as if the six wings on his back came alive, they blocked the 10th and 12th Holy Guard's offenses from behind. The brilliant golden light that met with the black arc turned into thin droplets. That's the fate Long Haochen's light thorn, which served as response, suffered. That's when Yating made her second move. This time, after intervening, her face became quite pale. The strain for a light mage at the premises of the 8th step to launch a spell able to block the attack of a powerhouse of the 9th step was just that great. Tears of the Goddess of Light was a single-targeted spell of the 8th step that Yating could use because of relying on Long Haochen's aura as the sign of light. Furthermore, as an ability at the supreme peak of the 8th step, this technique was already close to one step above her capabilities. Crocel's attack was not only stopped, but the blade in his arm was marked with a golden trail, which was dissolving his darkness elemental spiritual energy at a frantic speed. Don't forget that inside the Tower of Eternity, Long Haochen has another advantage, which is his supply of spiritual energy. This place couldn't supplement any elemental essence of other attributes than light and darkness. At the start of the battle, Crocel wasn't too aware of that, but as the battle followed its course, he felt that something was amiss. In other words, that the spiritual energy he consumed wouldn't be replenished. But don't think that in a situation where spiritual energy cannot be supplemented, a prolonged battle would be to Long Haochen's advantage. Crocel's attacks were unavoidable, and the four holy guards were not of much use in front of him. With the capability of the demon god of clear vision, there's no way he would be unaware that his spiritual energy was not refilled. In case he reaches his limits, it will undoubtedly drive him to desperate actions, putting his life on the table without fear of backlashes. So Long Haochen had to increase his power level to a sufficient level before he'd be driven to such actions. The diamond spear was instantly smashed to pieces, but Crocel's actions paused slightly. The spells from the four holy guards and Yating were just for the sake of stalling for time for Long Haochen. Such minor creatures dare stand in front of me with such impudence. Having been blocked consecutive times, Crocel was truly infuriated. Narrowing his eyes, he abruptly shot out a dark blue ripple from his head, aimed at attacking the four holy guards. The instant this dark blue glinting ripple appeared, the four holy guards immediately had frantic looks, turning suddenly into four bolts of light, which disappeared, assimilated by the Tower of Eternity. But even so, the bolts they transformed into dimmed a bit in color upon encountering that dark blue ripple. As Crocel was in battle with Long Haochen at the time the four holy guards appeared, he didn't pay too much attention to them. But very rapidly, he found out that they were actually undead creatures supporting powerhouse's souls. As a demon god of psychic attribute, he is the nemesis of undead creatures. The force of all undead creatures originate from the soul fire. But his psychic magic is the most expert at extinguishing such soul fires. The last psychic attack was a calamitous threat in the eyes of these four. Their soul fires were far from able to resist in front of Crocel, so they immediately escaped such an extreme situation. Otherwise, if their soul fires were lost, they had no chance of being resurrected. A jadeite glow extended everywhere the eye could see, like a mix of rain and fog. A figure abruptly came bursting out from within, releasing purpling golden glosses. And the mountain-like Haoyue disappeared all of a sudden. Armor transformation and fusion, Long Haochen's greatest fighting mode. With only storing power, Long Haochen was still not at the 9th step. Only by relying on Haoyue's armor transformation, could he launch sword blows with sufficient power to reach the standards of the demon god of clear vision. At that very moment, the enemy's right hand still hadn't dispersed the paralyzing effects on his left arm and confronted Long Haochen's attacks with only one hand. That mix of rain and fog was the ability Demon Wiping Flash, which was invented by Long Haochen. Blue rain, hibiscus of light carried a great breath of life, enveloping each of Crocel's possible escape routes. Can't you predict my next actions? Right, let's meet force with force. The long blade in Crocel's left hand was lifted, launching 9 blade projections through the sky, which gathered together with the longsword and collided with an ear-piercing sound. The two of them clashed only once, but Crocel's body was hit with 3 of Long Haochen's blows, which left 3 small bloody holes. On his left shoulder, dark blue blood was flowing, falling to the ground, letting out some ringing sounds. Though, this didn't come without a price for Long Haochen. Crocel's powerful 9 blades in one landed once onto his armor. However, the now pinkish-golden, transformed, golden foundation armor came back to normal after getting only slightly sunken for a bit, without triggering the effects of the soul-binding chains. Crocel narrowed his eyes, setting his drooping left arm into motion. He purposely let Long Haochen's attacks land for the sake of hitting him, and because of the poison in himself. As blood flowed, he had recovered some feeling in his left arm. Haochen's attacks didn't stop at that. As the two of them separated, his left feet tapped towards the ground, as he turned into a purplish-golden flash of lightning, once again rushing at Crocel. On his right hand, the aria of the Goddess of Light burst forth with a dazzling splendor beyond compare, and a layer of translucent orange-colored spiritual highlandized energy covered the sword. In the sky, a flashing line was traced toward Crocel. Lightning flash plus Azura strike. In his left hand, blue rain seemed to have faded away, as its dark green luster vanished gradually. But it vaguely seemed even more threatening. In Crocel's eyes appeared a trace of panic, due to having determined through clear vision technique the move Long Haochen was planning, because it would be hard to resist. After fusing with Hao Yue, Long Haochen's strength was already sufficient to clash head-on against him. Long Haochen couldn't let time drag on, but Crocel was also unable to recover his spiritual energy here. So it would be hard to guess who'd win. Raising the longsword in his right hand, Crocel suddenly turned illusory. 8 illusory images came out and dispersed from him, each having exactly the same physical appearance. Underscore dang, underscore with a violent clashing sound, Crocel's body was immediately pushed away by the spiritual highlandized energy-infused aria of the Goddess of Light. It seemed to want to fuse with these sorts of doppelgangers, but right at that time, a dark green gloss flashed by. Crocel only had the time to hit that dark green gloss with a knock of the longsword in his right hand, but only crooked its angle a little. Swinging his body with all his force, he could only twist his body with all his strength, doing his utmost to avoid taking damage. Azura strike was launched through blue rain, hibiscus of light. Dark blue blood fell down from the large scars on Crocel's side. A demon god's external spiritual energy was certainly great, but against the attack of a weapon of epic tier, his defense was insufficient to guard him from being wounded. But although Crocel sustained some damage, he still smoothly escaped. The other 8 clones were holding him, and as each of them was similar, true body blended in with them before they quickly separated and rapidly departed. Long Haochen narrowed his eyes, snorting in disdain. Suddenly shutting his eyes, he executed a swinging motion with the aria of the Goddess of Light in his right hand as a red glow flew out from it, shaped like a sort of eye. In the meantime, a golden figure appeared on Long Haochen's back, linking with him. In the meantime it shot a white ray, and the red glow went chasing after one of the 9 demon gods of clear vision, thus sifting the one from the many. You forgot that knights have an ability called Lock, and the so-called Saint Spiritual Stove. Long Haochen's resonant voice reverberated through the Tower of Eternity. That red light very rapidly landed on Crocel's body. And then, that white ray turned into a bridge between Long Haochen and him. Stamping his right feet against the ground, Long Haochen burst out once again, this time shining with a scarlet light. He was already sensing that the time of his fusion with Hao Yue was passing very fast, and that this ultimate form could not be maintained for many attacks. He had to kill the enemy within a short span of time, otherwise his only way left to him would be to escape. Sacrifice, an ability that Long Haochen had not used for a long time, was finally employed. With great surprise, he found out that the same sacrifice ability this time carried a far more powerful amplification than the former times. This was due to the increase of his external and internal spiritual energy. And with the increased toughness of his body, more of his latent capabilities as God's chosen one came out. The sacrifice ability also carried great stimulating effects on him. The aria of the Goddess of Light and blue rain, hibiscus of light, both let blade projections burst out. The condensed spiritual highland made them look no different from real blades, and the terrible spiritual energy led the 2 divine swords to let out light buzzing sounds. A resonant dragon chant could be heard from above Long Haochen's body. He didn't pay attention to the other 8 clones, and put all his focus on the demon god's main body. A golden light dragon rushed out. The 2 divine swords were like the 2 dazzlingly shining eyes of the dragon. Retribution Knight ability, Ascending Dragon Strike. As Ascending Dragon Strike looked about to hit Crocel, the 9 clones had twisting facial expressions. Immediately, the effects from Locke and the Saint spiritual stove used by Long Haochen alongside ascending dragon's strike suddenly changed direction, aiming for a clone on the lateral side.
Bang.
The nine of them being one, Crocel staggered back. Although his eight clones didn't manage to puzzle Long Haochen, he swiftly shifted his main body in the last instant, containing Long Haochen's attack to some extent. Even so, in sacrifice mode, Long Haochen was far too powerful. The superposition of his various boosts could only be described as terrifying. By chance, Crocel's left hand had already regained its ability of movement at that time. Although it felt stiff in comparison to the right arm, one more arm was always good to have in such a battle.
Dodge, flash.
Long Haochen's offense broke out instantly, as his comprehension in the sword intent gradually deepened. He was already assimilating his sword intent into his technical abilities. Used through his two ultimate holy swords, any ability gained a really terrible power. Two shining solar strikes followed, one orange, one greenish-blue. Two ardent miniaturized suns could be seen appearing in mid-air, just like meteors catching up with the moon, about to land on Crocel. Crocel gripped his pair of long blades with full force. Dark blue glows mixed with his darkness elemental spiritual energy, taking the shape of a thick sort of shield serving as an extension of his blades, glowing in dark blue.
Bang, bang.
As two violent explosions sounded out, Crocel drew back, feeling as if electrocuted. On each of his two long blades, a large gap had appeared in the middle. The boundless sword intent surging out along with his spiritual energy left drizzles of deep green and orange on his body. Crocel raised his head, and spouted a mouthful of dark blue blood in front of Long Haochen. Inside his blood were mixed a large amount of orange and dark green spiritual energy, producing puffing sounds in the air. From that spurt of blood could be seen the destructive power held by Haochen's sword intent. It was already invading Crocel's body. Long Haochen was not so kind as to spare the enemy at this point. His purplish golden figure stuck close to the ground as he kind of glided, chasing after Crocel in a flash. His blades were waved up together to launch demon wiping flash, shooting countless light rays towards Crocel. The demon god's face was already very pale. With an angry shout, his body crouched down abruptly and then, a pitch-black ray burst out from his forehead, covering his body like a dome. In the midst of a succession of ear-piercing sounds, that dome became in a disastrous state. But mystically, it maintained the same shape, except that it was now tattered, and Crocel abruptly rushed out from inside, sweeping his long blade with full force at Long Haochen. In Crocel's capacity as the demon god of clear vision, he obviously could see that Long Haochen's extraordinary state couldn't be maintained for a long time. Therefore, all this time he stayed on the defensive, only trying to drag it out. Long Haochen would inevitably collapse at some point. But he very rapidly found out that such a method won't do. A totally passive defense let Long Haochen display his offensive prowess, which he actually couldn't resist. Part 2 end here.